One of the biggest stories coming out of the Big House 8 was Banana's crazy 3-0 upset over Plup to knock him into losers at the very start of Top 64. This led to Plup going on one of the craziest losers runs we've seen all year, taking sets off of 9 top 50 players to make it all the way back to Grand Finals to eventually finish in 2nd place behind Hungrybox. This run got me thinking about what other crazy losers runs we've seen so far this year, so let's first take a dive into Plup's run at the Big House 8 so we can accurately compare 3 of this year's other strongest runs. Just looking at the ranks and the amount of players that he beat is astonishing on its own. To be fair though, he was almost certainly the favorite to win every single one of his sets of the event besides against Hungrybox, but still being consistent enough to win 9 in a row is extremely impressive. As a comparison, Plup played the most sets of any player with 16, whereas Hungrybox, who he met in Grand Finals, only had to play 11. He also had to face off with a wide variety of characters on the run. 3 Foxes, 2 Marths, and 1 Falcon, Sheik, Pikachu, and Falco. His loss to Bananas that sent him into losers is still pretty bad for a player at his level, but I don't think we should expect Plup to drop a set to him or any other Icy's player anytime soon. Overall, this is an insane run to match. And the only one who I think comes arguably close to matching it is Armada with his losers run at Evo that also led to him finishing second, after taking one of the few non-top 6 losses of his career against Swedish Delight. On this run, Armada faced off with every single member of the top 6 and defeated all of them except for Leffen, the Evo champ. A lot of these sets were shaky, dangerous, and even heartbreaking last hit, last stock game 3 situations, especially against Zayn, which may have been his last chance to take a shot at beating him in singles. But Armada still won those sets, and that's the part that matters. So looking at these two runs side to side, I think either of them have the right to be chosen as the best loser's run of the year, and can be argued as such. To argue for Plup over Armada, I'd say he picked up 2 more top 50 wins and cleanly won every single set after he got upset, unlike Armada. For arguing Armada over Plup, I'd say his loss wasn't nearly as big of an upset, especially because it was a best of 3, and beating every top 6 player except the guy who finished first place is huge. I've got my opinion on which deserves to be considered number 1 for the year, but I want to hear which way you lean and why down in the comments below. There's also a pair of losers runs that I think slot nicely into 3rd and 4th best slots for the year, but they could also be argued either way. The first of these runs comes from Z, who had a great run after proving that he's not as well versed in the Falcon matchup as he thought, and ended up placing 4th at the Big House 8, being overshadowed and knocked out by Plup. He did kind of luck out by getting 3 Foxes on his path, especially Esfat, who he's now 7-0 against for the year, but still a good run nonetheless. And if you missed out on watching his set against Rishi live, which he only barely won, I'd go and check out the VOD right now, as it was one of the best sets of the tournament right next to Bananas vs. Fiction. And the run we have to compete against this is from Gatsu at Shine, who silently had one of the best summers in Melee. This run didn't get nearly as much publicity as the other 3 on the list due to the hype surrounding Zayn's victory at the event, but taking 5 top 50 wins and beating the guy who knocked you into losers early to finish at 5th is quite an impressive accomplishment. It's also important to remember that Gatsu only barely made the cut on the summer rankings at 44th, so all of these players except for Michael could all be considered him pulling off an upset, which cannot be said for any of the players on Zayn's list. So then who do you think deserves the 3rd spot? To argue for Zayn, he had a pretty big variety of characters to face off with on his run, including Bananas, who was on a tear at the event, so beating these 6 and taking a game off of Plup is no small task. And arguing for Gatsu, he arguably upset 4 players, proved that his game 5 loss to Army was no big deal by 3-0ing him back, and really didn't take a bad loss to enable this run. And again, I have my pick for 3rd, but I don't want to purposely sway you guys one way or the other in your arguments down in the comments below. There's also a few honorable mentions I'd like to acknowledge. First is the most notable absence from this list, KJH's run to 9th at CEO after losing his very first match at the event to C15 to then win 10 sets in a row, but he only beat 2 top 50 players on this run, so it didn't make the cut. Nunn's run at Evo after losing to Dark Atma was pretty overlooked due to the insanity of the event, but beating Squid, Rocky, Shroomed, Rishi, and Lucky to miss top 8 at Evo by just 1 loss to Rishi was pretty crazy as well. And lastly, I have to mention another run from Zayn, who after losing the Marth Ditto the Hybrid, beat Nunn, Shroomed, Moki, and Esfat to make it all the way back to an amazing 5th place finish. And that about does it for this video. Sorry this really isn't up to snuff for the quality of my normal videos, but I've got midterms this week for my last year of college, so I didn't have as much time as I normally do, but I still wanted to put out something for you guys. I want to thank the people over in the Melee Stats Discord, especially Coster, Bits, Liquid, and Singstall for the help in making sure I didn't forget any of the big runs from this year. And to give you guys a little glimpse into the future, I have an exciting Rising Player Spotlight for a player who super overperformed at a recent event coming up soon, and also his name is mentioned at some point in this video if you want a better hint. And as of making this video, I currently sit at 9,940 subscribers, and I want to celebrate and be a degenerate with you guys as I hit 10k subs, so I'm going to be streaming the night this video comes out over at twitch.tv/saveasuntitled. I'm aiming for around 7pm Eastern Standard Time, but if we get close to reaching that gap, I'm going to start streaming earlier. So look out for a tweet from me over at SaveAsUntitled on Twitter, or just follow me on Twitch to get that notification as soon as I go live. And I think that's about it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching and supporting me for the last year or so, and I've been SaveAsUntitled, and I'll see you guys next time.